The historic moments of China-Philippines high-level exchanges and cooperation in various fields are the distinctive marks of China-Philippines friendship. In the past 6 years, China and the Philippines have adhered to a good neighborliness and friendship, work hand in hand for common development, actively promoted practical cooperation in various fields, and achieved fruitful results. China and has been the Philippines' largest trading partner for 6 consecutive years and has become Philippines' main source of foreign investment. It is also worth mentioning that in the past 6 years, have witnessed infrastructure cooperation that's booming in booming the highlights of China-Philippines practical cooperation. The two sides have worked together in carrying out a host of key projects such as bridges, highways, dams, and many of which, including the 303 railways, have been progressing smoothly. Since the outbreak of the pandemic, China and the Philippines have worked together and have been looking out for each other, and our bilateral cooperation has bucked the trend, illustrating the strong resilience and vitality of the relationship between our two countries. Well begun is half done. With the new Philippine government just taking office, China-Philippines relations are now standing at a crucial starting point. Not long ago, His Excellency Wang Qishan, the Special Representative and Vice President of China, visited the Philippines to attend the inauguration ceremony of President Bongbong Marcos Jr. He was followed by our State Councilor and Foreign Minister Wang Yi, who paid an official visit to the Philippines. We are thankful for the very warm reception accorded by the government of the Philippines and especially the Department of Foreign Affairs of the Philippines. So the two high-level visits within 1 week, setting a new record for the high-level exchanges between our two countries and breaking a new ground for our bilateral relations, demonstrated the profound importance that China has attached to the bilateral relations and our firm support for the Marcos administration. Just as President Marcos has said, our strongest partner has always been our close neighbor and our good friend, the People's Republic of China. Looking ahead, China will continue to prioritize the Philippines in its neighborhood diplomacy and maintain continuity and stability in our friendly policy towards the Philippines. China is willing to strengthen communication with a new administration of this country, follow through the blueprint for bilateral and friendly cooperation, and shift our relations to a higher gear. In line of President Marcos Jr.'s ideas on national governance, China is ready to work with the Philippines in 4 key areas of large-scale agriculture, infrastructure, energy, and cultural and people-to-people exchanges. I'm confident that both sides will be committed to becoming good neighbors that help each other, good relatives that share mutual understanding and enjoy close bonds, and good partners that pursue cooperation and win-win results, so as to push for the upgrading of our bilateral relations and usher in a new golden age in our bilateral relations. To conclude, I would like to thank the SM Super Malls again for your strong support of this event. I would like to thank again for all distinguished guests for coming to this event. Thank you very much, and Mabuhay. Thank you.